Hi folks, Glyn here, just dropping in with a new video, which is actually an update to the Droplets one that I posted last time, and that was episode 98. Now, it's been great having quite a lot of positive feedback about that video, especially from those of you who didn't know anything about Droplets and didn't even know they existed. So it's great you're going to get some use out of it. But I have been contacted by a few people who had a few problems. So what I thought I'd do is I'd quickly throw this kind of interim video together for you to replicate the problem that they're having so you can see it, but then also show you how you can overcome it so that you have no problems again using Droplets. So the problem is this. On the screen now, I've got a JPEG image. When I did the earlier video, it was a TIFF image. So this is a JPEG. So let's just say now that I'm going to record an action for this JPEG. Again, I'm using the Glyn's Actions folder. We'll say create a new action and we'll do JPEG conversion. Now, all I'm going to do with this one here, like before, we'll go image, adjustments, hue and saturation. We'll colorize it, whack that up, whack up the saturation, click OK, and then we'll stop it. So nothing really different to what we did last time in the first video. So now that we've got that, let's create the droplet. We go File, Automate, Create Droplet, and we're going to choose where to save it. Again, we'll do the desktop. It's going to be called JPEG Conversion. Click on Save. We can see in the play section here that we're going to use the Glyn's Actions folder, and we're using the action that we just called Glyn's Conversion, and we'll just click OK. So let's just backtrack on that one there. We'll dive over to the desktop. So now on the desktop, we can see we've got this folder here, sorry, this droplet rather, called JPEG Conversion. So the problem that people have been having is now when they drag a file over onto that droplet and then release it, they're getting this little dialog box comes up here. Now we know that when we use Photoshop, we get the option here when we're saving them to decide what quality we want that JPEG to be. And that's what we use this little slider for here. So it's bad enough if you're doing this with one file, but if you've got a whole folder full of images that you want to actually do conversions on, and this keeps cropping up, that is not speeding up your workflow. So I want to show you how you can actually overcome that. So let's just cancel this. We'll stop that, we'll rewind that, and we'll get rid of that. Don't save. In fact, let's just go to the desktop and we're going to get rid of that conversion there, or that droplet rather there. And then we're going to go back to Photoshop. So now then, let's open up a JPEG. We'll open up this JPEG here. In fact, let's go to this test folder I've got here. I've got a test folder, loads of images in there, and we'll click open. So now we're going to create a new action, specifically because we're using a JPEG. In fact, let's get rid of that other one there. So we'll do the same thing. We'll click on Glyn's Actions folder, click on the new action icon there, and we'll call this JPEGs, just so we know it's easy to remember. And we'll click record. Then, like before, we'll go image, adjustments, and hue and saturation. Exactly the same steps again, just so that we've got something to compare it against. Click OK, but this time, rather than me now stopping that action, I am going to save it. And we'll go File, Save As. Keep it in the same folder there, click on Save. It exists already. And this is where we get the options here, the JPEG options. And I'm gonna say, keep it at quality 10 and click OK. Then I'm gonna stop my recording of that action. Right, so let's just backtrack now and let's get rid of that and don't save. So now that we've got the new action, we'll go File, Automate, Create Droplet. So let's create a new droplet here and we'll just call this one JPEG, exactly the same name as what the action was. It's going to be on our desktop and we'll click Save. We know that we're using the same action here. It's in Glyn's Actions folder. We're using the action called JPEGs. But the important thing over here is where it says override action save as commands here. Now, ordinarily, if we leave that little box there unchecked, the actual droplet is going to save it exactly how you're telling it to do it within this dialog box here. So it's just going to tell it to just simply save it and close it. If I put a little tick in that checkbox now, basically what this is saying is it's going to override the save part of the droplet dialog here. I hope this makes sense. So basically what it's going to say is it's going to ignore what we're saying here and it's going to use the save that we did when we initially created the action. And that's where we told it that we want to use it as quality 10. So we put a little tick in there to override this Create Droplet Save section. Then we're going to click OK. Now that we've done that, let's dive over to the desktop. And here's our new droplet. And here is our folder. I've got a folder here, just like I did in the first time I ever showed this. A folder full of images. Loads of them in here. Let's get rid of the one that's already been done so we can tell that we're going to have a whole folder full of new conversions. So what I'm going to do now then, bear in mind these are all JPEGs. I'm going to click on it, drag them over, drop them onto the droplet. A little bit of a flash there. Looks like nothing's really happening. But if I now double click to open up the test folder, we can see that all those conversions have been done. And we've not had that dialog box pop up asking us every single time what quality we want it to be. So like I say, it's just a very, very quick video. It's kind of found it easier to record this rather than write it down to explain to people why they're having a few issues with JPEGs. But hopefully that's sorted out. And I shall get on now with recording another video for this week. Take care and I'll speak to you soon.